like, Melbourne's a fantastic place to set up a business, especially a manufacturing business. The resources that are available in terms of skills, in terms of a supply chain, it's all close to us here. We've just spent the last 2 or 3 years building a carbon fibre manufacturing facility for Boeing locally in Melbourne.
ADA is a manufacturer of clothing, principally, but mainly for the Defence Forces. Of most importance to our organisation is the fact that we have the supply chain on our doorstep. Our most significant raw material suppliers are based here in Victoria also. Our customers on the doorstep, DMO, just down the road here in St Kilda.
The Australian Industry and Defence Network was set up in 1995 to look after and support the small to medium enterprises in Aden, Victoria. We have 252 members, so we're what we call a jewel in the crown of the national body. We've recently set up the Victorian Defence Vehicle Alliance, which will look to collaborate around Land 400 and Land 121, which are major land projects happening in the defence space. We've had companies who have been very successful on the Joint Strike Fighter project.
Iran signed several agreements with Lockheed Martin and BAE Systems on the F-35 Joint Strike Fighter plane. We are exporting over a third of the vertical tails for the Joint Strike Fighter into the US. And we also design and manufacture the engine trailer, which we ship to the US.
There are a number of extremely high-performing organisations, and DMTC is extremely lucky here in Victoria to be able to draw on those.
We get great support in terms of research and development through organisations like the DMTC, DSTO, VCAM, and also CSIRO, all based with significant operations here in Melbourne. We have a skilled workforce base because this is the largest defence manufacturing state within the country.
There's multiple universities in Melbourne training up young engineers. There's lots of apprentices come through other industries. So everything we need right here in Melbourne.
With the announcement of the Defence Science Institute, which is a collaboration between the Commonwealth through the STO and Melbourne University, that's obviously a testament to the capabilities that are here in Victoria.
The research organisations that we've been dealing with, like the DMTC and VCAM, that's really going to open up doors offshore for us because we're producing some world-first type products now.
We have a 24-hour airport, plus also we have the largest port in Australia. So logistically, it makes it very easy to move products in and out of Melbourne.
We're going to continue to export our tooling and automated machinery to the rest of the world. We've shipped into Canada now, we've shipped into Denmark, we've exported to the UK, to a couple of sites in the US.
I think defence anywhere is a global business, and that's increasingly so. For Australia to be able to compete in that, it has to be underpinned by technology, research, development and innovation. And if you look at what Victoria is doing to position itself as the epicentre of that, certainly in Australia, I think the future's got to be very strong.